Good morning class. So in this class also we will continue with prepositions, but prepositions that can be adverbs. I want you to open up to page number 174 in your Renan Martin, that is your middle school English grammar and composition, right? So let us first read the sentences or the examples which are given below. Have you seen an aeroplane go up? Now the word in italics up is a preposition. The little boy climbed up the ladder. So up again over here is a preposition. But the usage is different in both the sentences. Let us see how. In the first sentence, the word up adds something to the meaning of the verb, which verb? Go over here. It is therefore an adverb modifying the verb go. We know that an adjective, it modifies the noun or a pronoun. Similarly, an adverb modifies the verb. Right? So, this is also preposition. This is a preposition and go is a verb. Now, in the second sentence, the word up shows the relation between the climbing of the little boy and the ladder. So, the subject is the little boy, climbed is the verb over here, right? Where the ladder is the object. So up over here has been used as a preposition. Now it will be seen that many words which are prepositions, when they are used with a noun or a pronoun, are adverbs, right? It will be seen that many words which are prepositions when they are used with a noun or a pronoun. So over here the little boy is a noun, so it is when it is, right? The ladder is also a noun. So when it is used with a noun or a pronoun, many words, they act as prepositions. Whereas they are adverbs when they stand alone and modify a word in the sentence. So modify a verb. This particular word up over here is modifying the verb go. Now let us see further. There are thieves about. So there are, modifying which verb over here? Are, about. So about over here is the adverb. Now we often talk about you. So the verb over here is what? Talk, right? And we is what? A pronoun. You is a pronoun. So over here, about is a preposition, right? It is showing the relation between we and you. What do we often do? We talk about you. So about over here is preposition. Now second sentence, second pair of sentence, that is, I have heard that before. Now over here the word before has been used as adverb. It is the word before is qualifying or modifying the verb have heard, right? Now again let us see the usage of before in the second sentence. He arrived there a few minutes before me. So over here he is the subject, right? And a pronoun. Me is the object over here and also a pronoun. So therefore, before over here has been used as a preposition. Now again, third pair of sentence. He lives close by, next to, very close. So we over here, the word by by has been used as an adverb. And it is modifying which verb? Lives. This is the verb here. Now I require my new coat by Monday. So I is what? It is a pronoun and it is also a subject over here. And what is it? Require my new coat. So object is till when, relation. It is showing the word by over here has been used as a preposition because it is showing the relationship between the person's coat and the day Monday, right? Now let us look at the fourth pair of sentence. The train is in. So the verb over here is, and in has been used as an adverb. It is modifying the verb is. He is in bad health. Got it? So in, he over here is a pronoun and the subject also of the sentence. Bad health is the object. And therefore, in is used over here as a preposition. Now let us look at the fifth pair of sentence. The flowers are coming on, meaning to say blooming. So the verb over here is are coming. This is the verb, so this is an am verb. This is the subject. The flowers are the subject. Now let us look at the next sentence. I hope to see you on Tuesday. Again the word on. I is a pronoun. It is also the subject, right? And Tuesday is the object over here. Therefore, on is used as preposition. I hope I am making sense, children. If again you have some confusion, please rewind the video and go through it again. Several words are used sometimes as adverbs and sometimes as prepositions. So what do we have to look for? We have to see that when they are used with a noun or a pronoun, they are prepositions. When used with a noun or pronoun, they are prepositions, and they are adverbs when they stand alone and modify a word in the sentence. And which word will that be? That word will be a verb, because this is what we know about adverbs. They modify the verb or they add more meaning to the verb in the sentence. Now, a word is a preposition when it governs a noun or pronoun. It is an adverb when it does not. This is a little bit vague, but then this, if you will keep in mind the above explanation, I hope you will not have any kind of confusion. Now, let us see another pair of sentences. We have two tables. One is of adverb, and in the other table, the same word which has been used as adverb has been used as preposition. I could not come before. So come is the verb, therefore before is the adverb, right? I came the day before yesterday. So I is the subject and is also the pronoun, and yesterday is the object. Therefore before is preposition. The wheel came off, meaning to say it came off means got loose from the vehicle. So came is the verb and off over here is the adverb. Now the driver jumped off the car. So the relation, the driver is what? A noun. It is also the subject. Verb is jumped. The car is the object. Therefore off has been used as preposition. Let us move on, right? Move is what? The verb. So therefore on, the verb on is modifying the verb move. Hence it is an adverb here. Now let us look at the next sentence. The book lies on the table. So the book is the noun. It is also the subject, right? And the table is the object. So the word on is showing the relationship between the book and the table. Hence it is a preposition. Take this parcel over to the post office. Take this. So take is what? The verb. Take where? Take over. So over here is adverb. So now children, one thing to note, please make sure. Now over here in this particular sentence, an object or a complement has also been used, just to add more meaning to the sentence. So please do not get confused over it. Right? So let us see, the word is already in italics. You just need to identify whether it is an adverb or a preposition. So we are showing what is happening here. So it is the word over here is modifying the verb take. Hence it is an adverb. He rules over a vast empire. He is what? A pronoun, and it is also a subject, right? Now over, vast empire is the object. First, it is easier, children, if we segregate the noun pronoun and the object in a sentence. And if we find such things, and then we should look at the word given, whether we it is an adverb or a preposition. So over here is a preposition. I have not seen him since, right? So have not seen him is a complete verb, right? Or verbal phrase, phrasal verb you can say, and since over here is the adverb. Now I is the noun, it is also the subject. Yesterday is the object, hence since is the preposition. Right? I hope I am not clear, children. If there is any doubt, please rewind the video and see it again. Now, exercise 5 and exercise 6 are homework. You need to do it on your own. In case you don't get it, we'll discuss it during the online class. Thank you. Stay safe, stay blessed.